Hi, I want to introduce our Spring 20 release. As always, we keep innovating and expanding our offerings. In this release, there was a main focus on mobile and further connect our products. I'm proud to say that all PDF Butter apps work together in perfect synergy. Want to learn more? Visit our academy on our website, pdfbutter.com. Let's take a look at all that is new in PDF Butler, Sign Butler, and Collaboration Butler. It seems we never stop innovating on PDF Butler. Every release, it is a big fight to put together the roadmap as we get so many ideas via our customers. Let's take a look at the highlights of this Spring 20 release. Rich text. Please do not use rich text to create a layout on your document. We have so many capabilities on adding the layout and managing the layout via your Word document, but in cases you need rich text, we have far-reaching support now. We even support rich text images, so images that are dragged and dropped on your rich text boxes, and these are just perfect for your case articles or your texts that your employees write directly into Salesforce. Page breaks on table config types. What are these? A table config type, I guess you all know, and you use it a lot. These are repetitions of tables that you want to do, or you want to maybe show a table or hide a table. Now, when you repeat tables, you've had already the option to break them or split them via one or two enters. Now you can break them and split them over pages. Means that every table will just start on a new page. Customer ID for .config and packs. Well, this is a very hot topic for the moment. A lot of our customers are asking for it. In the old days, well, if you create a lightning component or if you add a lightning component, a button, a process builder, whatever, you always required the ID of the .config or the pack. This ID is of course different on every environment, every org, every sandbox you are working on. Now, we can use the customer ID, means that this is a unique identifier that remains the same for all environments and every release and every stage of PDF Butler. So it means that you can just migrate and release your process builders and your page layouts without any issue anymore. No need to manually change the IDs. Excel. This is a complete overhaul, actually. We have created an Excel version 2. We now support very complex data structures and Excel structures, and also the performance, I think, is times 100. We are able to process so much data in these Excels at this moment that it's just crazy. Improved mobile experience. Yeah, we already had a mobile experience, but we were just not happy on it. We really want the best for our customers. Now we have created a new component. That's a new mobile component. It's just a lightning component. You can just easily plug into your pages via buttons or via lightning components. It's just so easy and it gives a perfect result experience to your users. Mass volume processing. We see more and more customers that want to build big reports and big documents and are actually running into the Salesforce limits. Yes, those Salesforce limits. When selecting too much data, and I'm talking here about thousands and thousands of records, we of course hitting those Salesforce limits, and when these documents get too big, well, Salesforce cannot handle it anymore or does not want to handle it anymore. Now, we have found a workaround. We have a mass volume component in place, and if you want to really create big documents and use large amounts of data, you can use this mass volume product as easy as all of the other PDF Butler components. Mass picture loading. What is this? Well, we see more and more FSL customers popping up. So there is Field Service Lightning, and they all take pictures. They take a lot of pictures on their work orders and their child work orders and tasks. And we see that we need to process those pictures more faster and better. So the speed is always a concern of us in PDF Butler. So what we are doing now is just getting these pictures more faster and putting them faster into your documents, even going passing by the Salesforce limits. How cool is that? Integration with Collaboration Butler. Yeah, well, our new tool, Collaboration Butler, is really very interesting for everybody that's using Office 365 and really wants to get a 360 view on what's happening in Office 365 and Salesforce. So we now have a perfect integration to create a document via PDF Butler and actually store it on in SharePoint, OneDrive, or Microsoft Teams. The merge options on pack.configs. So a pack, you can create multiple documents, which is very cool, but you can choose now to merge all of these documents into one big PDF or not merge them. Well, now we have more options there. You can say, I want to merge the first and the second one, but not the third and the fourth one, and so forth and so forth. Very complex structures to actually completely manage and control this merging of multiple documents that you want to generate in one go. We have also started some component libraries. We see a lot of questions from customers, improvements that they want to do, kind of experiences that they want to build for their internal users. And instead of bringing all of these components into our managed package, we said it would be better to open source these components. So we have a lot of components now that are actually just open source. You just have to ask for it. You will see all of the explanations popping up on our academy, so you know which ones exist. But yeah, we have so many and they are just available for you. Just ask for it. So why ask for it? Well, it's open source, and of course, we do not want everybody to just copy paste our code and claim that this is invented by themselves. And then next to that, we have done so many improvements and fixes. It's just too much to talk about in this overview. So look at our academy and you will see what has been popping up and what is new and what of features we have. Sign Butler, our digital signature tool. I'm proud to say that we are at par with most of the signing solutions out there. Maybe we even have more functionality in certain regions when it comes to dynamically choosing who has to sign and integrating with Salesforce.com. Yes, we have a perfect integration into Salesforce.com. Your users can manage and follow up the entire signing process without ever leaving their beloved Salesforce.com. So, what's new? We have a silent processor. It means that we have a better user experience, more clear for the end user. You just click a button, the document is generated, and it's automatically sent for digital signature. This silent processing can be called via Process Builder, a Flow, Apex, whatever kind of automation you want to build in there. And of course, it can also be called directly from the user interface. We have branded emails. Yes, branded emails. So your brand can really be at the center of what you're sending out. If you have multi-branding, multi-language experiences that you want to bring, we can support all of that via our branding email features. Of course, every digital signature tool needs a logic around expirations and warning mails, means that and notifications, reminders, so all of this is now part of our configuration. You can really build your configuration how you want, make it automated, make it exactly how your users would expect it, and your customers will just get expiry mails, reminders, notifications, all automatically via Sign Butler. There are far more email types now, so it means that we don't only send an email for an, or you cannot only manage the email and the content of the email for instance, the email to ask your customer to sign, but also every email on expiration, warning, notification, rejection, revoking, every email is now specific and you can completely manage that content for every process you want to support. The mobile experience, of course, yeah, that's our main focus point. So go full mobile with Sign Butler, no problem there. Just have your entire flow in mobile. Get signers from multiple data sources. As I told you in the beginning, we have far more options now to get really to really know who are your signers, have your more complex processes in there, and you don't have to get all your signers onto your contract or opportunity. You can really get them from multiple data sources, so really support your process that's there without having to customize everything for your digital signature tool. So we have more delivery options for the signed files. Up to now, you can when a file was signed and sent back to to Salesforce, then this file could be saved as a file in Salesforce or as an attachment. Now we support so much more. You can say, I do not want to save it. I want to control the save myself by using an actionable and then picking up the file and saving it somewhere else or doing something specific. But you can also save it as a file to add as a version. Means that if you have multiple signed files, you can just add versions there. You can also overwrite the file. Means that if something was signed, but then an update comes, you can just overwrite the signed file if you do not want to keep a history of that. And of course, the integration with Collaboration Butler. It seems only normal that when all of your processes and your data, your files are stored via Collaboration Butler into Office 365, SharePoint, OneDrive, or MS Teams, that the signed Butler files, the signed files coming back towards Salesforce, are also stored in Collaboration Butler. All of that is now possible. Collaboration Butler. Get that perfect 360 degree view on your files in SharePoint, OneDrive, or MS Teams directly related to your Salesforce.com records. It seems like the new kid on the block, as we are still creating our logo. Any ideas are welcome, by the way. But it is very mature and we were able to create a strong customer base very quickly. And our customers just love it. This is our second release, so let's take a look at what's new. We have auto-login, means you just surf to your record, you just navigate to your record, and the record knows where to go, what folder in SharePoint to show related to your Salesforce.com record. You do not have to do anything, you immediately see the data. We are now also mobile friendly, means that you can just on your mobile have your integration with Office 365. No need to log in thanks to the auto login functionality. You have that perfect 360 degree view everywhere you go. Of course, on the community, we also have to be present. If you want to share files with your community users, you can just add Collaboration Butler to your community and you can share the files that they want. Of course, all in that perfect relation with your Salesforce.com data. Inline actions, if you want to create new folders on SharePoint or OneDrive, you can directly do that from Collaboration Butler. You don't have to surf to the OneDrive or the SharePoint to create a folder. Directly do that from Collaboration Butler. A preview on all file types means you do not have to surf to your SharePoint. You can just see the preview directly in Salesforce, even on your mobile. So it makes it very easy to really follow up and validate your files that you have linked to your record. Drag and drop functionality. Everybody would think that is there. So you can just go and drag and drop your files from your folders directly into Collaboration Butler, and they will be stored into SharePoint directly. Pack support, take direct actions from your documents. This is a case where, for instance, you are working on a contract together with your legal team or your engineers, and they are all working on that contract in SharePoint or in Microsoft Teams, OneDrive. And at a certain moment, the contract is done. What you want to do, you just want to go to Salesforce as all of your sales information is there. You have your contacts there. You have all of your information who has to get the document. So you just want to click on the document and say, I want to send this via mail or for digital signature to my customer. So with PAC support, that is perfectly possible. A refresh button, of course, sometimes you will have to have done a change or somebody has done a change, created extra files, so you can just refresh that component. You don't have to refresh the entire page in Salesforce. We show more information on the files, so you can quickly see what kind of file you're dealing with, when it was last modified, who has modified it. All of that information is now in one view for your users to be more able to directly take actions on those files. And more configuration options for admin. So you really want to have all of the options for an admin to put that component anywhere in Salesforce, on any page layout, anywhere in the page layout you want, and really control that look and feel of the components. Do you want to have these inline actions for your users? Do you want to be able to auto-log in? All of this stuff are now perfectly manageable via direct configuration of the Lightning component. Want to learn more? Do not hesitate to contact us via mail or via phone and schedule your personalized demo. Want to check out PDF Butter for yourself? Of course, via our Academy, you have all of the information to get started. Just go to our Academy via our PDF Butter website. Have fun!